at the end of this hour. And so we share announcements that can bring you deeper into community with each other and with the world. So we have a few announcements and invitations to help out. If you are willing to take lawn bags, we still have some lawn residual, but it is much knocked down, so a big thank you to everyone who has helped us over the weeks. We will continue to add to it, but hopefully not in such bulk as we have been. Monday at 11 a.m., there is TOPS meeting at the church, and this is to help anyone who's been struggling with weight gain and weight loss. So this is a good supportive community to help you in that journey. Our rummage sale is this week. It starts on Thursday and goes to Friday. We'll clean up on Saturday, but we start setting up today after church. Any who are able to stay after to help with that process, or who are able to come throughout the week to set up, that is going to be a great help.
became the first African-American to sing in an opera at the Metropolitan Opera in New York. But maybe the best part of Marion's dreams was that she used her accomplishments to work for racial equality, like Martin Luther King Jr. But she did it with her singing. She said that her dream was to leave behind me the kind of impression that will make it easier for those who follow. She wanted to pass her dream on, and she did. Now many African American men and women sing opera here and all around the world, thanks to Marian Anderson's dream. Our colorful umbrella is a sign of joy and hope, even on rainy days. Today we'll add a phrase from Ms. Anderson on our prayer umbrella. Sing what you love. Let's offer a repeat after me prayer. We offer thanks,
we offer thanks
for dreamers true,
for dreamers true,
for all they are,
for all they are,
and all they do,
and all they do.
Let us become,
let us become
dreamers too,
dreamers too,
and bring new life,
and bring new life
to me and you.
Me and you.
And the people said, Amen.
With that, let us join together in our hymn, Guide My Feet.
Serve God, future generations will be told about the Lord, and proclaim God's divine deliverance to a people yet unborn, saying that God indeed has done it. Our second reading is from the book of Acts, chapter 8, verses 26 through 39. Then the angel of the Lord said to Philip, "Get up and go towards the south to the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza. This is a wilderness road." So he got up and went. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury. He had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go over to this chariot and join it." So Philip ran up to it and heard him reading the prophet Isaiah. Philip asked, "Do you understand what you're reading?" The eunuch replied, "How can I unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to get in and sit beside him. Now the passage of the scripture that he was reading was this: "Like a sheep, he was led to the slaughter, and like a lamb, silent before its shearer, so he does not open his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who can describe his generation? For his life is taken away from the earth." The eunuch asked Philip, "About whom, may I ask you, does the prophet say this, about himself or about someone else?" Then Philip began to speak, and starting with this scripture, he proclaimed to him the good news about Jesus. And as they were going along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, here's water. What is to prevent me from being baptized?" He commanded the chariot to stop, and both of them, Philip and the eunuch, went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away. The eunuch saw him no more and went on his way rejoicing. Dear Lord, thank you for giving us the scripture this morning, and let it work in our hearts and minds for your glory.
In the dancing community, or in at least many, there are clear distinctions between men and women. In traditional fashion, men are the leads. They're the ones who lift the bodies and pick the steps. And women are the follows. They're the ones who go along with the decisions made. This is how you learn to walk. there's more to the complexities of human life and experience than our laws can encompass. And so they talk about the life, ministry, death, and resurrection of Jesus, and as they go along, they see the water, and in which point we hear, "What is to keep me from being baptized?" Had he went to someone else, not called by the Spirit of the Lord, I imagine that there would have been a long list. In truth, in the history of Christianity, we have come up with all kinds of lists to keep people from being baptized or being invited into our community or taking part in the wholeness and wonders of human experience. We blame it on all kinds of things, but the truth is that the Spirit works whether we're ready for it or not. that maybe confuse or astound us. Maybe this is a difference that falls within appearance or falls within ideology. We know that for each of us, we have an other. And we live in a day and age when it feels like the others are specifically turned against each other. I think of politics all the time when I say that, because we have seen that tension. But we've seen racial tension. We've seen these tensions continue to call us apart when we're actually called to be pulled together, to call to see the humanity, the gift, and the beauty and the ability of others, and then also present what we have, what we have the ability to bring and share. May the Spirit of God call you into strange and unusual dances that you do not expect to go. But may your joyful spirit see it as the Spirit of God, and may you move with intention and grace. The Lord be with you. As we head into a time of communion, for all those who are online, we invite you to gather something to eat and something to drink, and we will bless it as a community and take it as a community. For all those who are present with us today, there are cups with wafers on the top and juice on the bottom. If you have any trouble peeling I feel like calling them clamshells. If you have trouble peeling our clamshell communion, there are bottles of juice and crackers in the back that are much easier to open. And if you just wave, then we will have someone bring those to you. At St. John's, it is always important that all those who feel called are welcome to this blessed table that reminds us that Christ died, Christ resurrected, Christ will live again. Let us center ourselves for this holy moment and celebrate the feast together. On the night of betrayal and desertion, Jesus took the bread, blessed it, and broke it. Giving it to the disciples, he said, "Take and eat, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for the world." Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup of the new covenant, poured it, saying, "This is my blood, which is shed for you. Take and drink. And as often as you drink it, remember me. Consecrate, therefore, by your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine, and let them encourage our faith in you. Amen." Take and eat, for this is the bread of life, shared with you. that they might be used in the building of your great and wondrous kingdom, here on earth and beyond. We thank you for the